rapid test has been done on 2 patients. They have turned out to be positive. But we want to know which type. You know, there are different types of causes of cholera.
Okay.
There is the Ogawa, Elto type. So that one, we are sending the media today. Okay. Actually, one vehicle has left.
Okay.
With the commodities. Eh? We need a tent, okay. We need buckets, we need a cholera bed. You know, whenever there is cholera, we have something called CTC. CTC is a cholera treatment center.
Okay.
We don't necessarily put them in wards. So we put a tent outside, the beds, okay. And the cholera bed has a hole in the middle, whereby choo inatoka, bucket inawekwa chini. Hii kija, natolewa ingine inawekwa. As they get the drips, even on both hands or even on the 4 limbs.
Okay.
But the good thing, they have all the commodities. What they are lacking is a bit of human resource. The few guys who are there have been overwhelmed.
How many are there?
Yeah?
How many are there?
There is one nurse each.
Okay.
Plus some community health workers and a nutritionist.
And how many centers are there?
Two centers. Okay. Llleret and Telesgai. Okay. But the epicenter is in Telesgai, which is just on the border with Ethiopia. Okay. Actually, this problem was first diagnosed in a health center called Bubua on the Ethiopian side.
Okay.
But these people are just homogeneous. They move around.
Yeah.
That's how it has got to Telesgai. So we are not sure today. People are being told.
Okay.
But one adult and one child passed on. The adult passed on as he was being brought.
Okay.
The child passed on in our facility.
Okay.
So now what we are doing is we have talked to some partners. They have given us vehicle.
Yeah.
One vehicle which was loaded with everything that we need.
Yeah.
With concern, it has already left.
Okay.
So there are a few other things which have remained, and human resource, which we are planning to send today, this morning actually.
Okay.
On the other hand, we have talked to a very important partner called MSF Belgium. They are very good in cholera outbreak management.
Okay.
So they have got all the raw data from us, where it is, how many people, and all that. So they are planning to move there. And when they move there, normally they take over the CTC, the cholera treatment center.
Okay.
We are going to get the update this morning.
Okay.
This thing started the previous week, actually.
Okay.
So there are a few commodities which they didn't have. We sent an ambulance from here. We sent them all the things they didn't have, like ORS for the children, some treatment like doxycycline for the children. We sent that. But right now, the problem is the numbers are big. They have been overwhelmed. So it requires a cholera treatment center, which we are responding to. The first vehicle has left this morning, carrying the tents, the buckets, the beds will go today.
Okay.
Yes.
What mitigating measures do you have in place, maybe back in the villages?
There they are continuing to treat.
Yeah.
Yes, they are continuing to treat. The treatment is ongoing. The commodities are there. The only problem is human resource.
Okay.
Yes, because all these people need IV fluid.
Yeah.
One person can even have one on this hand, depending on the level of dehydration. You know, the cholera causes vomiting and diarrhea. So the biggest complication is dehydration. If you just control that, survival is almost 100%. Then we also give antibiotics to prevent the bacteria from multiplying.
Okay.
So that is what we are doing. We started last week, actually. So this week is just a follow-up. The only problem is the number increased. So we have to send some. We are earmarking 8 persons, 8 nurses.
Yeah.
4 for Llleret, 4 for Telesgai, to go and beef up the human resource. Then we have a surveillance officer who will also go, and also a lab person.
Are you planning to institute any movement restrictions across the border?
You know, the restrictions is there.
Yeah.
But those are very porous borders. People who don't know, they are even borders.
Okay.
They are just moving. So it's very difficult to really do that. But as a public health measure, we are also going to take care of, also a public health in charge of Nodo is also going to look at the hotels and all these other public health actions. They have even started fumigating the corridors and the tent, I mean the place where the patients are. So those are other measures we are taking along the control lines.
Okay.
Yes.